What is going on, guys? I welcome you to your fourth HTML5 and CSS3 tutorial by ifechtner.com. And in this tutorial series, we will be making a full functional website, and these tutorials are aimed at beginners to intermediate level programmers. So now we will continue our discussion on making all our sections. Right now our web page is just a simple old boring white page with some logos and with some links, but we would like to make it something like it. And right now you would be thinking, how the hell we are going to do that? Excuse me. So we would be using the CSS cascading style sheet, external cascading style sheets, to style our sections, these sections, into this format. So trust me and just bear with me. So let's make our sections and articles now. So I go to my template.html file, and under the aside tag I use the section tag. The section tag is basically the main body tag or the main content tag of your website. Under the section tag we can have different articles. So we would like to have two articles. One would be HTML5 and CSS3 tutorials, and the other would be computer networking tutorials. So in my section tag I would add another tag, another child tag, that is the article tag, and I close the article tag. And under the article tag I know I would be using heading 1, and that heading 1 would say HTML5 and CSS3 tutorials. And I close that tag, and under that tag I just want to add an heading 2, and which would say that these are the video based tutorials, and I close that tag. Now whenever we are using headings, it is better to give to use the H group tag to group those headings, so it would be easier to format at the later stages. So I use H group tag and use both heading 1 and heading 2 under that H group tag, and we would be giving IDs to all these tags later on. And under that heading I just want to add a paragraph for all my HTML5 and CSS3 tutorials. Please click here, or whatever you would like to write, you can do that. And I close that tag. And one more thing, guys and girls, that you can divide your article into three parts, that is your header part, your main content part, and your footer part. So how can we do that? That is simple. That if you want to give it under the header tag, I use the header tag, so we would be able to stylize it in with yellow background. So I give the header tag under the article tag. So you can our article has also got the header tag, the main body tag, and the footer tag. So I give footer by ifechtner, and I close that footer, and I close that article. So I would just copy it with Control C and paste it with Control V, and I would just make some changes. I do not want to type it again, so I just say networking tutorials, video based tutorials for all my networking tutorials, please visit HTML.ifactner.com, byifactner.com, and so on and so forth. Now we have got our articles in our section. So I save it and run it in Chrome and check now that we have got two articles, and this is our left hand bar, right? This is the navigation, and this is our header. So now we want to make a footer. So how can we make a footer? With the footer tab, a tag. So I just use a footer tag. If it's not formatted right, I just use the tag tab, and I close the footer tab. And in the footer you can write anything. So I would say copyrights by ifactner.com, and I save it and I click on run, launch in Chrome, and now we have got all the tags if you would like to see. So now we have got the by ifactner and copyrights by ifactner.com tag. So now we have made all the sections, but now we need to format those sections into something like this, and for that we would be using an external cascading style sheet. The style sheet is used to for the styling purposes of your page. Right now your page is simple, old, dumb, white web page, and it's not very attractive. So to make our style sheet, we click on File, New in the Notepad++. You can use Notepad if you would like to, and I click on File, Save As, and I save it as type CSS, cascading style sheet. And this is the cascading style sheet, and I would name it, let's suppose, ifactner.css. Now we have got an ifactner.css file, cascading style sheet, and a template.html file. And now we would like to link our web page with the cascading style sheets and start beginning our styling. And usually we link our cascading style sheet in the head tag. So I would use style sheet. Okay, guys and girls, we would do it in our next tutorial. So because the time is up, and we would continue our discussion. So take care. Bye-bye.